Social media has broken B2B sales as we know it. Sales has always been an inherently social activity, with connections being made and appointments being set based on the size and strength of the representative's network. Historically, joining the right country club or networking could give a sales professional access to the decision makers he needed to talk to. Social media has changed it all. So what can your business do in just 140 characters? At last count, 61% of B2B companies are using social media, and most see a 100% increase in lead generation on average. Social selling leaders enjoy benefits of 45% more opportunities created and are 51% more likely to achieve quota. The two leading platforms for sales include Twitter and LinkedIn. Twitter is the world's fastest growing network, but why should salespeople use Twitter? The answer is simple, because your prospects are there. Twitter's reach is enormous, with users tweeting 500 million times every day and entering 1.6 billion search terms. That's a lot of people, and some of them simply have to be buyers. Between 50 to 70% of businesses have a Twitter account, and 94% of them are tweeting, and it's working for them. A recent study demonstrated that companies who use Twitter get twice as many sales leads as those who do not. One example is IBM. IBM reported a massive 400% increase in sales of their products after piloting a social selling program. Twitter will allow you to be part of the most relevant conversations as they happen, spot opportunities first, build relationships, and deepen customer trust. More commonly known for its use in sales, LinkedIn is another effective social media tool. LinkedIn provides access to a huge expanse of business professionals and is an efficient way to locate prospects and gather information about buyers. A whopping 80% of B2B social leads come from LinkedIn. LinkedIn leverages over 400 million professional profiles, with LinkedIn's network growing at a rate of 2 signups per second. LinkedIn is all about business. The mindset and intent are naturally more receptive to solving business problems, with 50% of LinkedIn members reporting they are more likely to buy from a company they engage with on LinkedIn than a company they do not due to credibility and familiarity. LinkedIn successfully generates sales as 65% of companies acquired B2B customers through the platform in 2013. Discussion groups produced 86.3% of these conversions. Craig Rosenberg states, LinkedIn is the ultimate platform to deliver thought leadership to your audience.
When you use the power of social media platforms to maximize your sales performance, you're sure to surpass and ultimately outsell your competition, a task that is difficult for even the best sales team. PeopleLink's survey found that while 73% of B2B sales professionals felt that at least one social network was valuable, only 31% said that their sales process actually included social networks. Only 1 in 4 sales professionals in this survey felt that they actually knew how to use social media for selling. We believe that businesses need to align social media with their sales and management strategies, and most importantly, they need to align these strategies with the buying process and determine exactly who is a part of the buying team. Harvard Business Review estimates that 60 to 80% of the time, the buying process begins without the use of a sales force. This is because social media has opened the floodgates of information exchange. So how do you access and control this information flow? Management must be aware of the 5 ways that their sales team can use Twitter and LinkedIn for social selling. Twitter can help you identify your prospects while allowing you to create private lists and keep them organized. These prospects are your targets and should include influencers and active users that possess interests or views related to your brand. While prospecting can not only be expensive and very time-consuming, it is essential for any sales team. Yet properly qualifying prospects is one of the biggest challenges salespeople face. LinkedIn can help you pre-qualify your prospects, save time and frustration, and even improve your closing ratio for current and new clients alike. For B2B in particular, LinkedIn is a critical tool for making your prospecting faster, smoother, and at the end of the day, more profitable. You want to start the conversation, retweet, favorite, ask questions, and eventually direct message. The audience you interact with should include influential people that want to engage with your company as much as you want to engage them. This is your opportunity to qualify your leads and build referrals. Twitter and LinkedIn allow you to devote time to the right conversations and get to know your audience, which will ultimately deepen your relationships with current clients and prospects. Gathering and analyzing insights provide important information about your client and targets. Social media allows you to gain insight on members of the buying team and provides a strong foundation for building rapport.
Overall, social media allows a sales team to move further and faster down the sales funnel.
The current research and theory on social selling revolves around the idea that the consumer buying process has fundamentally changed in the past decade. With internet access and social media usage continuing to grow, consumer buying processes have evolved. Studies show that 55% of buyers will turn to social media first for relevant information about potential buying decisions. In order to adapt to this interconnected world, corporations are using service-dominated logic to revamp their sales models, shifting from a push to a pull promotional strategy. Recent research from a Sales Guy consulting shows that Twitter and LinkedIn are extremely valuable for the front end of the sales cycle. Social sellers outperform their peers in terms of revenue attainment, and they were found to be 23% more likely to exceed these quotas by more than 10%. This evidence directly correlates with the fact that the majority of social sellers could track social media back to at least one closed deal. Looking forward, Statista found that global social commerce revenues are expected to grow to $30 billion by the end of 2015, which will be a 50% increase from last year's $20 billion. The top three reasons corporations aren't using social selling are legal risks, PR issues, and employee productivity. Employees, however, are surprisingly productive with social media usage. 50.1% spend less than 10% of their work time on social media, and well-equipped salespeople were able to reduce their time prospecting on the job by 96%. Despite these benefits, almost 75% of B2B salespeople have not received any formal social selling training from their companies. While risks do apply, researchers agree that refusing to engage in social selling is the worst risk of all. Instead, corporations should invest more in social selling training and structured policies for salespeople and anyone else that might represent the company online.
When we talk to various B2B companies, their success using social selling derived primarily from creating demand, improving relationships, and driving leads. Jill McBride from Forza Marketing praises social media's improved ability to create demand and awareness for B2B companies. A sales rep from Brand Loyalty outlined the value that social platforms can bring to relationships by learning more about potential and current clients and reinforcing relationships through online interactions by using tools such as LinkedIn's discussion groups. Trish Bonberg from Air Miles Canada explains how social selling has the potential to drive additional leads that are not intentionally pursued. The value of associations in social media is unprecedented and can lead to positive unintended consequences for B2B companies that actively participate online. While there can be many benefits and risks to social selling, the biggest risk of all, now that your customers are all linking, sharing, tweeting, is to sit on the sidelines and leave social selling to your competitors. For more information on social selling, please see the following resources.